So let's come up with a backward error result for solving a lower triangular system. And you know, what we've already argued is that you need to focus on the specific algorithm that you use in addition to the operation that's being performed. So on the right here, we have a dot product based algorithm. And why do we use a dot product based algorithm? Well, that's because we have error results for the dot product. So those probably will come in handy. So we want to solve a lower triangular matrix times x equals y, where L and y are given. We want to compute x. And at some point in our algorithm, we've gotten to this point right here, where we have computed x0 already, and we want to compute the next element of x, chi1, right? Now, we have computed x0 already, but obviously we haven't computed the exact result because we're doing this in the presence of roundoff errors. So we really have computed an x check so far, a computed result. And, you know, let's make the assumption that that corresponds to a slightly changed lower triangular matrix L00. Okay. What we would like to do is say, okay, given what computation goes into computing chi1, and given what we know about how error is incurred when doing so, can we somehow throw that error onto matrix L so that we can expand our argument to yet another element, and then an inductive argument would allow us to show it for the entire linear system, for any matrix L that's n by n. All right, that's the approach. Now, what goes into computing chi1? Well, in exact arithmetic, chi1 would be computed as psi1 minus L10 transpose times x0. And then the result of that would be divided by lambda 1, 1. However, we will never have, or we typically don't have x0 actually available, because x0 was computed only approximately. So we need to put a check on this. Okay? So the approach we're going to take is we're going to say, okay, given what we know about how error accumulates in a dot product, let's come up with an expression of how that error accumulates when computing x1 check, the computed result when you perform this operation. Let's then see if there's an error result that allows us to throw the error back into L. And let's see if we can then come up with some bounds that allow us to come up with a nice result for the entire operation. And we do so by stating a lemma that focuses just on this operation. You will then be asked to prove that lemma. And then we can state a theorem, once we gain some insight from that, on how the total error might be accumulated into L, thrown back onto L and bounded. And then you will prove that in a homework as well.